Now we are going to discuss about fundamental analysis. So basically, when we enter into investments, we will do two core analysis. One is fundamental analysis and another one is technical analysis. So in this session, we are going to discuss fundamental analysis. So what actually the fundamental analysis is? It is an approach to determine intrinsic value. What is the intrinsic value? Intrinsic value is nothing but what ought to be the price. What exactly the price should be of a certain stock which is trading in the market. Okay, that price is considered as what ought to be price. We'll consider it as intrinsic price or intrinsic value of the share or any security, and also true value. So intrinsic value or true value of the share. So this is the approach which will help us to know the intrinsic value or true value of the share. And its objective is to identify the underpriced or overpriced securities. Underpriced or overpriced securities. I said that this is the true value of the share according to certain valuation techniques. Already we have used bond valuation technique. So value of the bond is equals to means present value of future stream of inflows or interest we have done. Along with the present value of the redemption value that has given us value of bond. That value of bond is nothing but the intrinsic value or true value. So how it helps us? Then after calculation of intrinsic value and true value, we need to compare it with the market price. Suppose some stock X is trading at a rate of 120 rupees. Per share, let us suppose, and according to our valuation, if we got 100 rupees as its value, so our valuation is saying that the true value of the share is 100 rupees, but it is trading in the market at 120 rupees, then that means it is overpriced. So it is overpriced means in the coming future definitely it is going to come down to its original or true value. So that overpriced security gives an indication that it is time to sell your security. The same way, if a market price of a share of Y suppose is 80 rupees, it is trading in the market and its current market price is 80 rupees, whereas my valuation says that is it is or it should be 100 rupees. So according to my valuation, it is underpriced. So underpriced indicates in the coming future definitely its price will go up and reaches its intrinsic value. So this underpriced securities gives an indication to buy. So this fundamental analysis helps me in calculation of intrinsic value to determine underpriced or overpriced security, to make a decision of sell or buy or hold a security. So for this reason, we will do this fundamental analysis, which is a bit complicated to understand. But when once you understand the concept thoroughly, you can play with the numbers or stocks in the stock market. So what is the intrinsic value of a stock? It is estimated by discounting the company's prospective earnings stream or the shareholders' prospective dividend stream. So when I said prospective earnings and prospective dividends, my focus is on future, what I am going to get from the future. So based upon their potential, now I can calculate intrinsic value of my share. So when I say that it's from future, it purely depends on economical factors, industrial environment it is into and the relative company financial to which it belongs to a particular industry. So this is giving an indication that whenever we start investing, we'll do investing, we need to establish some quantitative relationships. So fundamental analysis seeks to establish quantitative relationship between economic, industry and company factors in order to forecast earnings and dividends. So for that we'll do quantitative analysis of all these three, and this can be done in two ways. The broader one is economy as a whole. This is economy is a combination of group of industries, and industry is a group of combination of companies. So group of companies form industry, group of industries form economy. So if we study from economy to company, then this is called top down approach or EIC analysis. Suppose instead of going coming from top to down, if we go from company to industry, then to economy, then this is called bottom up approach or CIE analysis. Majority of the financial analysts will go with the top down approach or EIC analysis, and those who go in favor of technical analysis, they'll say it is better to go with CIE analysis. So fundamental analysts prefer to go with EIC analysis.